What is the first thing you do in the morning? Wake up, snooze your alarm, and sleep back again. Even if you manage to wake up, checking your notifications, chatting with your friends, and going through social media, there are so many things that are waiting for you inside your phone. And finally, when you realize time has passed and you rush over to start your day, it is hard to live a dream productive life. Unorganized schedule and time management leading you to become even more unmotivated. Even if you start your assignment with lots of motivation, the world is filled with temptations. YouTube, Netflix, TikTok, and Instagram, and when you realize, wasted time has passed again.
Hi, my name is Itsuko.
I'm Aoi.
Today, we will be discussing what we could do to stay productive as a middle school student in Japan. So, what actually is productive? According to Cambridge Dictionary, causing or providing a good result or a large amount of something is productive. More precisely, productive people can use their time wisely, know how to manage their tasks, and work efficiently.
This kind of productive lifestyle is becoming popular today on social media. For example, when you search that girl on TikTok, Instagram, and other social media platforms, you will find tons of videos of people having perfect lives.
But that girl is also a controversial topic. It could motivate yourself and inspire you to become productive, but it may also be too difficult for some people and can be toxic.
We took a survey about the reality of productive life among our grade. First, 72% of people have more than 2 hours of screen time per day, which is in general is considered too much. And more surprisingly, 26% of them have over 5 hours of screen time. As the result, only half of them is capable of staying productive in their daily life. And other people who's not, most of them wish to have a productive life while it is difficult for them. In addition, most people would like to improve their personal time as the first priority rather than to raise efficiency in studying, increase time with friends and families, etc.
So what can you start with to manage your life? Time management is the most important thing. But how can we do this?
The first step is to become aware of your current situation. Start by writing down 1. What activities and schedules you have. 2. How much time you have for study or work. 3. How much time you have for yourself. 4. Are there any unproductive, wasted time during your day? And 5. Are you overwhelmed or overtasked by anything?
Writing this out and knowing your current life is the first step to organize it.
The next step is to actually start organizing your time and tasks. Here, we will show examples with Google Calendar, but any other sources like physical calendar, notebook, or other online organizing system would work as well. Then after you are able to know how much time you have, the next step is to distribute the tasks and start organizing your schedule. Here, I just filled out the calendar, so next I will list up the tasks and to-dos that I have for the day. Then, distribute the tasks into the empty spaces you have. Be sure to think of how much time it would take, and this will allow yourself to become more aware about your study schedule as well as your normal schedule. Depending on the schedule, you could change the time. In this case, I moved this task to next morning. Setting a goal has helped me a lot. It might seem like an easy thing, but there are tips to make it even more achievable. Start by writing down the main big goal that you want to achieve. Then what can you do to achieve this goal? And break it down into even smaller pieces. It may also be a good idea to create a rewarding system to match each goal. Changing or restructuring your lifestyle would be a great way to boost your motivation and improve your life to become even more productive. For example, a good habit that you can make is wake up earlier, breathe in the sunlight, and make your bed. Or you could try to eat healthier than before. To stay productive and motivated, it is also important to have a break where you could release your stresses. It depends on each person, but workouts, sports, read, journal, meditation, or more other things would be a fun and productive break time for yourself.
All of this would help you stay motivated and productive. Of course, it is hard to become perfect from the first time. Making small efforts into a habit will help you keep up.
With our experience, being productive allowed us to finish assignments without being rushed, which didn't put ourselves into stress, and have more time for our own good.
This also made us become more positive about our lives, which we think is the most benefit.
Thank you so much for watching this video. We hope this would help you improve your life.
Bye!